Welcome to NurseMinder. My name is Tammy, and today we are talking about IV lines, in particular, what to do to prevent bubbles from getting into them, and two, how to troubleshoot them when they do appear. And we're going to talk about that right after this.
Welcome back. My name is Tammy, and this is NurseMinder, and on this channel, we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released.
Welcome back. We're talking today about the IV line, priming it so that you don't get air bubbles in it, and two, troubleshooting when they do appear, because they always seem to appear, don't they? Yeah. So let's first look at our tips to prevent air bubbles in our IV line.
The supplies you will need are your IV infusion fluid. In this case, I'm going to use normal saline, and your IV line. And in this case, I'm using the Alaris pump infusion set.
All right, confession time. I don't have an IV pole. So we're going to use that nail in the wall as my holder for my IV solution. You got to do what you got to do, right? Okay, so I've already checked my IV fluids. I know that the expiry date is good. It's the right fluid for my patient. And I'm going to take my IV line and get that ready. One of the very first things you want to do is lock this roller clamp. So we're going to take this all the way down. And that is the first step we're going to do. I'm also going to remove all these pieces of paper. They don't need to stay on here. You're welcome to keep them on. That's not a problem. And stretch out my line. Okay, now the second thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hold up my IV line. I'm actually going to create a second clamp, and I'm just going to hold it like this. We're going to remove the blue sheets from my fluid. And we don't want that to touch anything. I'm going to remove the protective sheath on my IV. I'm going to switch sides here. And we're going to spike the bag. Okay, so that's it. I'm still holding this tight. Let me zoom in a bit for you. I give it a squeeze and I filled in that fluid here. And now I'm going to stretch this out, and I can see I do have a bubble in there, but that's okay. It's going to come out. Now we're going to open up my clamp. Now, if you have the Y ports, you can hold those Y ports upside down. And what that will do is, as the fluid is priming through, it will fill the base of this first, and then it will carry on. So let's open up my clamp. And you can see the water is now flowing through. And it's got that one little bubble it's chased already out. Final inspection, and this line is bubble free. So next we're going to talk about troubleshooting when there are air bubbles. So I've put an air bubble in here so that we can actually go through this, and it's quite a large one. I'll bring it closer for you to see. Let's see, you can see that there's this air bubble right here, and that's quite a significant air bubble. We definitely want to get that out. So this air bubble in particular happens to be above the first lure lock. All we're going to do is grab a sterile syringe, cleanse the hub, and then we're going to withdraw fluid so that the bubble comes out. All right, so we're going to do our cleaning. I always want to do a 15-second scrub to make sure that we are reducing the risk of any microbes being introduced when we do attach our sterile syringe. Even though it is sterile, we still want to clean the hub. Then we're going to just screw this on. And here's the other important piece, is you need to actually clamp below the line. So let me anatomically make, we're going to clamp below so that the fluid that this syringe is going to pull is actually coming from above, and it's going to grab that air bubble. All right, so let's see if you can see the air bubble as it comes. So I've removed all of the air. You can see it inside the syringe here. Detach. and my line is now clean. Now with the Alaris line in particular, sometimes the air bubbles get in this sheath. So we're gonna remove this sheath now. And this is the part that sits in the Alaris pump, and this is the part that will beep when there are air bubbles. And so you can stretch this, it is stretchy, and then just flick it because air will rise. So depending on which direction you want those air bubbles to go, you're just gonna flick that, and then hopefully those air bubbles will clear out of that line. Okay, so now what happens when the air bubbles are below the sheath? And so I've got one, where is it now? Here they are. You can see those traveling along beautifully. Well, we don't want those in there. So I'm gonna clamp. And now these air bubbles are just above the port that's going to my patient. So I would do the same process here. I would clean the hub, clamp below. Imagine this is attached to my patient, clamp below, attach your 10cc syringe and allow for those bubbles to come out. So we're gonna clean. Always 15 seconds. There's no cheating in this because this is, you know, an extremely important process to make sure our patients are safe. I know 15 seconds feels like a really long time, but it's not that bad. We're gonna attach your sterile syringe, clamp below, so I've got this pinched off so I'm not pulling blood back from my patient. And where is that? Here it is. We're gonna watch those. Get those air bubbles next. Gotta make sure I unclamp. That's a pretty common thing. Ain't nothing moving if I'm not unclamped. There we go. And you can just scooch those out before they even get to the patient. And there's one more coming. There we go. Now, here's a question is, what if this is medication? We definitely wanna make sure the patient gets that medication. So I'm gonna detach here. This fluid can continue now to go into my patient. And then I could reinsert the medication into this bag. You would clean this port, you would attach your blunt end needle, clean this port, and you could infuse the medication back into the bag so the patient is receiving all of it. All right, so as a quick review, before you prime your bag, you're gonna close the clamp. That's your first clamp. And then you're gonna make your second clamp by holding the line tight up against your chamber. So there we go, close our first clamp and we're gonna make a second clamp. That's gonna help ensure that we don't get bubbles. If we need to troubleshoot that bubble, we're gonna grab a sterile syringe and attach it to the port that's closest to the air bubble where the air bubble has not passed yet. Then we're going to create a clamp below that port, attach our sterile syringe and withdraw the air. Now, if it happens to be past the very last port and it's headed towards your patient, you can disconnect from the patient, let it run. So we're gonna lose just this little few cc's here to get that air bubble out and then reattach it to your patient. Thanks for watching. Now, if you like this video, give it a like, hit the bell so you get notified when the next video is released and subscribe. If you have any comments, please share them. This video was actually created because someone had asked me, what do I do when? So I do listen to your comments and I do respond. Thanks again for watching, and you know what's coming next. Make it a great day.